Hey guys, Brian here. Welcome back to another This Old Shop Barn Edition. I guess what I'm calling that. It's getting closer to shop. So, as you can see, we got the rest of the wall up to the steel. And the next step I gotta do is start tying in the roof section to this wall. So that's what I'm gonna work on next. There's apparently been some doubts as to whether or not I'm the one that's actually working on this project. So I'm gonna try and leave this filming while I do some of the work. And then you can see how I go about doing this. I wouldn't think it'd be very exciting, but some people want to watch me work, so that's what you're going to get. I think you get the idea on that. I'm gonna save my battery for when I get to doing some building after I tear all that off. So, bring you back. Okay, so I got the rest of the wall torn out. So it's time for me to start framing it up. So I'm gonna grab a drink and then get started on that. Okay, as usual, I outworked my GoPro battery. But anyway, show you here on these boards what I do. I cut them to length, and I put marks on each end for my height, so I know where to screw them. And then I take the lift, put them up there, and put the screws in them. So, see if I can get that. Yep, that's how you do it. Two more up, so the rest is all just repeating. I'll cut them, screw them up. Okay, so as you can see, you've gotten down to the short part up there. I didn't film a lot of that for you. I figured after you got your demonstration, that was good enough. It takes a lot of time and effort to remember to turn it off, turn it back on, in order to try and save the battery for the thing to actually record, because that's a big problem. But anyway, got looks like 3 or 4, maybe 5 more rows up there to do, so I'm going to try and use up some of these scrap pieces I've already cut up. There's no need in using full width pieces up there. That's in the attic, so if it's got some gaps, it really doesn't matter. So I'm going to get to it and let this film until the batteries run out. Show y'all that's how humid it is out here. I don't know if I show up, I'm probably reflecting, but. I'm thinking, just touching the wood gets it wet with sweat. Sweat equity. Well, there it is. Another wall completed. Looks pretty good compared to what it started out as. So I'm happy with it. I guess that means we're 3/4 done on walls. Maybe a little more than that. This wall is really tall. It took a lot of lumber to do that one. It's like 40 feet to the top on this side, so it's getting way up there. That 36-foot extension ladder, it won't reach. So all I got left to do now is another whole wall, a floor, a heating system, an electrical system, lights, and probably a half a dozen other things. But we're getting closer, so I can almost see the boring mill sitting in the corner over here. I guess it actually could be sitting in there right now if it had a floor and foundation and be as good as it is on the trailer. It can actually keep the weather off of it somewhat there now. It's not going to be raining in this end anymore, except for where it's coming through the skylights. So probably fixing the roof be next, now that the wind won't blow it all off. So it'll be that or working on the wall. But for now, I gotta go spray some beans. So thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, and I made it to the 4,000, so I guess 5,000 is the new mark. So we'll see how long that takes. Hope you enjoyed.